Good morning, brothers and sisters. Please stand as we begin our Eucharistic celebration.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, coming together as God's family, let us acknowledge our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to one another and to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You heal the wounds of sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You intercede for us with your Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, Almighty and merciful God, that we may in truth receive a share in the resurrection of Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The crowd in Philippi joined in the attack on Paul and Silas, and the magistrates had them stripped and ordered them to be beaten with rods. After inflicting many blows on them, they threw them into prison and instructed the jailer to guard them securely. When he received these instructions, he put them in the innermost cell and secured their feet to a stake. About midnight, when Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God as the prisoners listened, there was suddenly such a severe earthquake that the foundation of the jail shook. All the doors flew open and the chains of all were pulled loose. When the jailer woke up and saw the prison doors wide open, he drew his sword and was about to kill himself, thinking that the prisoners had escaped. But Paul shouted out in a loud voice, "Do no harm to yourself. We are all here." He asked for a light and rushed in, and trembling with fear, he fell down before Paul and Silas. Then he brought them out and said, "Sirs, what must I do to be saved?" And they said, "Believe in the Lord Jesus, and you and your household will be saved." So they spoke the word of the Lord to him and everyone in his house. He took them in at that hour of the night and bathed their wounds. Then he and all his family were baptized at once. He brought them up into his house and provided a meal, and with his household rejoiced at having come to faith in God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your right hand saves me, O Lord.
Your right hand saves me, O Lord.
I will give thanks to you, O Lord, with all my heart, for you have heard the words of my mouth. In the presence of the angels, I will sing your praise. I will worship at your holy temple and give thanks to your name.
Your right hand saves me, O Lord.
Because of your kindness and your truth, you have made great above all things your name and your promise. When I called, you answered me. You built up strength within me.
Your right hand saves me, O Lord.
Your right hand saves me. The Lord will complete what he has done for me. Your kindness, O Lord, endures forever. Forsake not the work of your hands.
Your right hand saves me, O Lord. Please stand.
Send to you the Spirit of truth, says the Lord. He will guide you to all truth.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Now I am going to the one who sent me, and not one of you asks me, 'Where are you going?' But because I told you this, grief has filled your hearts. But I tell you the truth, it is better for you that I go. For if I do not go, the Advocate will not come to you. But if I go, I will send him to you. And when he comes, he will convict the world in regard to sin and righteousness and condemnation. Sin, because they do not believe in me. Righteousness, because I am going to the Father, and you will no longer see me. Condemnation, because the ruler of this world has been condemned." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
My dear brothers and sisters, we've heard tragic and, shall we say, or maybe we can say, heavy stories in our readings today. Paul and Silas were persecuted and was put into prison. And on the one hand, Jesus now expressing boldly his farewell to his apostles. But the stories ended well. Nakalaya naman sina Pablo at si Silas sa kanilang pagkakakulong at nabigyan naman din po ng lunas ang mga alagad sa pamamaalam din ni Jesus sa kanila. But what served or who served as their comfort and their strength during these moments? If you listened intently in our first reading, it sounds weird that during midnight, Paul and Silas, as what we've heard, were praying and singing hymns inside the innermost cell kung saan sila inilagay, while the other prisoners were listening to them. Wala po tayong narinig na meron bang nairita, nagalit sa kanila. Maybe as they were singing as well, the other prisoners were listening and also joining them in praising God. Alam nila na kinulong sila, pero hindi sila nakalimot na mayroon silang Diyos sa kanilang buhay na kaya nilang tawagin at bigyan papuri kahit sila ay nakalagay sa kanilang preso. The sadness on the one hand of the apostles cannot be imagined, but Jesus assured them, "Someone will be there for you. The advocate will be with you." My dear friends, sadness, the prison, and the chains, if we wish to say, are so real today and would sometimes differ in their own little ways. Yung malungkot na lamang po, masasabi po natin na ito din ay isang kulungan para sa atin. Ang maranasan pa ang iba't ibang pagkabigo, kasalanan, kahinaan at pagbagsak, preso at kadena na po iyan sa atin. Marahil preso, kadena o kalungkutan din po ang sakit, yung bigo, yung maloko at maiwan, yung sakit na ginagawa ng ibang tao, yung kawalang bahala ng iba para sa atin. These chains, prisons, and sadness can be so real and so near to us. But today, the apostles, Paul and Silas, are reminding us this sadness, this prison, the chains will never silence us to love God and give praise to God. Hindi kaya ng kadena ng preso o marahil ng kalungkutan na pigilan tayong magmahal at magpuri sa Diyos. In your own chains, in your own prisons, remember that God is with you. Remember that you can always call on to God. Remember that you can always hold on to God. Tao po tayo at marahil sa kabila ng mga bagay na ito, magrereklamo tayo at mahihirapan tayo. Pero may Diyos na hindi umaalis sa buhay natin kahit man tayo ay pahirapan. God never leaves, even when sadness, the prison, and the chains cannot be even detached from us. We have a God alive in us, to whom we can always call, to love even we are in chains, and to praise for the rest of our days.
Please stand.
We now pray the Oratio Imperata ad petendam pluviam. Together, God, our loving Father, creator of our earth and of the universe, and of all the wondrous elements of nature that sustain your living creatures, we humbly ask you to grant us relief from the extreme heat that besets your people at this time, disrupting their activities and threatening their lives and livelihood. Send us rain to replenish our depleting water sources, to irrigate our fields, to stave off water and power shortages, and to provide the water for our daily needs. At your command, the wind and the seas obey. Raise your hand, Almighty God, to avert the continuing rise in temperatures, so that your people can engage in productive undertakings,
and our young people can pursue learning in tranquility and comfort.
Merciful and gracious, generous God, open our eyes to the richness and beauty of your creation, and instill in us a deep love for this earth and all that is in and around it. Teach us to be wise stewards of your creation, so that we may always use them responsibly and protect them from abuse and exploitation. At this time of crisis, dear Lord, move us to share more, to serve more, and to love more. Loving God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, you entrusted the Filipino people to the special care of Mary, our Mother. Listen to the prayers that we bring up to her, our Blessed Mother, to intercede for us, for the protection of our land and our people, whom she loves. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Lady of Guadalupe,
pray for us.
St. Rose of Lima,
pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
San Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us. Please stand.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that we may always find delight in these Paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. Through him, the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising, the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Jose our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
piling ko sa inyo ay magmahalan. Mula ngayon, kayo'y aking kaibigan. Inamo sa dilim at kababa.
Please stand.
Let us pray. Hear, O Lord, our prayers that this most holy exchange, by which you have redeemed us, may bring your help in this present life and ensure for us eternal gladness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
This coming Sunday, it's Mother's Day, and we invite all mothers and the families to be with us in our Eucharistic celebrations. We still have our regular schedules at 8 a.m., 10 a.m., and 6 p.m. Mass. There will be blessing of mothers every celebration of the Mass. And after the 6 p.m. celebration, we shall be having the Rosary procession at the Plaza Roma, and a short procession around the Plaza Roma in honor of Our Lady of Fatima on the eve of her feast day this coming May 13. Please invite your friends and all of us to be with us this Sunday as we celebrate the Ascension Sunday, the Mother's Day, and the eve of the feast of Our Lady of Fatima. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. The Mass has been offered.
Thanks be to God. Thank you.